In a previous video, I described the Zed Baker navigation system used by the American pilots during World War II over the Pacific. In the comments section, many of you have frequently asked how Japanese Navy pilots were able to navigate back to their carriers. In this episode, I would like to introduce you to this topic. Japanese carrier pilots frequently didn't even have radios in their aircraft because of weight and reliability issues, and therefore had to rely on simpler methods. These methods were widely used in aviation all over the world, when there was a lack of navigation aids, before the era of GPS or inertial navigation systems. The first one was dead reckoning. Dead reckoning is a navigation method that involves calculating one's current position by using a previously determined location and advancing that position based upon known or estimated speeds over elapsed time and course. The primary tools for dead reckoning include a compass, a chronometer, airspeed indicator, and navigational charts for plotting courses and recording positions. Pilots would begin with a known starting point, such as an aircraft carrier, and then use their compass to maintain a constant heading. They would record their speed and the time spent traveling in that direction to plot their current position relative to the starting point. This process is iterative and cumulative, meaning that each subsequent position estimate depends on the accuracy of the preceding ones. One of the obvious problems when returning to the aircraft carrier was that it was in constant motion and its position may have changed significantly after the aircraft completed their mission. Therefore, the pilots received detailed information on the course and speed of the carrier during the pre-flight briefing and took this data into account when planning the return route. The other main challenge in dead reckoning is posed by the wind. Wind drift causes the aircraft to deviate from its intended course. If not correctly accounted for, this can lead to significant navigational errors. In this example, the pilot maintaining a northern heading with the wind from the west will be constantly pushed to the east, making it impossible to reach the target. That's why pilots need to constantly adjust their heading to counteract the wind's effect. He points the aircraft slightly into the wind, so the plane's nose is not aligned with the flight path, but rather angled. This way, while the aircraft's actual path through the air is angled into the wind, its ground track remains straight. This technique requires accurate estimation of wind speed and direction. For this, pilots use meteorological reports and their own in-flight observations. However, over the ocean, the only thing that could help them estimate the direction of the wind were the whitecaps. The other method was celestial navigation. This method involved using the position of celestial bodies, such as the sun, moon, stars, and planets. The sextant was the primary instrument used in this method. It allowed the observer to measure the angle between a celestial body and the horizon. The main components of common sextant are the index mirror, mounted on the movable arm. It reflects the image of the celestial body. The horizon mirror, partially silvered mirror that allows the observer to see the horizon directly and the reflected image of the celestial body at the same time. Index arm, a movable arm attached to the frame that moves the index mirror. And the telescope, attached to the frame, which helps the observer see the horizon and the reflected image clearly. The observer holds the sextant and looks through the telescope at the horizon. The index mirror attached to the movable arm reflects the image of the celestial body down into the horizon mirror. The observer moves the index arm until the reflected image of the celestial body lines up with the horizon seen through the telescope. Once the celestial body is aligned with the horizon, the angle between them is read from the graduated arc. The angle, combined with the exact time of observation, is used to determine the observer's position using celestial navigation tables. However, marine sextants are not useful in aircraft because they depend on a visible natural horizon, which is often not available at the altitudes where aircraft operate. Additionally, the movement and stability conditions differ significantly between ships and aircraft. That is why specialized bubble sextants were designed for use in aircraft, which allowed for stable measurements even while in motion. The bubble sextant uses an artificial horizon created by a bubble in a liquid-filled chamber, similar to a spirit level. The navigator aligns the celestial object with this bubble. This feature makes it useful in environments where a true horizon is not visible. Japanese pilots and navigators used the bubble sextant Sext 39, which was a copy of the American Army Air Corps sextant A8. That's it for today. If you like this type of presentation and would like to see more, please support this channel by leaving like or comment, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching and see you next time!